zeros of polynomials. Given this polynomial, p of x equals to a sub n x raised to the power n plus a sub n minus 1 x raised to the power n minus 1 plus a sub 2 x squared plus a sub 1 x plus a naught. The value of x for which p of x is equal to 0 are called the zeros of the polynomials. To find the zero of the polynomial p of x, put p of x equals to 0 and solve the corresponding equation. Example, find the zeros of the polynomials, that is, p1 of x equals to x squared minus 5x plus 6, p2 of x equals to x squared minus 1. Solution, note, you are to equate the above equation to 0, that is, p1 of x equals to 0. Now, we have x squared minus 5x plus 6 equals to 0. Breaking it down to get x squared minus 3x minus 2x plus 6 equals to 0. That is, we factorize it. So you have x into x minus 3 minus 2 into x minus 3 equals to 0. That is, factor it out. You have x minus 3, x plus minus 2 equals to 0. Hence, the 0 of p1 of x equals to x squared minus 5x plus 6 are 3 and 2. Now let's look at p2 of x as equals to x squared minus 1. Now equate it to x to get p2 of x equals to 0. That is, x squared minus 1 equals to 0. Factorizing it to get x minus 1, x plus 1 equals to 0. Now x minus 1 equals to 0. Minus 1 cross over to get x equals to 1. Now, x plus 1 equals to 0. 1 cross over to get x equals to minus 1. Hence, the zeros of p2 of x are 1 and minus 1. Now, at this juncture, it is important to emphasize that a polynomial is different from an equation. For example, p1 of x is equal to x squared minus 5x plus 6. Now, is a polynomial. Why x squared minus 5x plus 6 equals to 0 is an equation. Note, the equation is equated to 0. As you have seen from the above examples, x equals to 3 and x equals to 2 are the zeros of p1 of x equals to x squared minus 5x plus 6. Why x equals to 3 and x equals to 2 are the root of the equation x squared minus 5x plus 6 equals 0. In general, a polynomial of degree n, you have an n zeros. Why an equation of the nth degree will also have a nth root? Please do want to subscribe for more of this. Thank you.